Let me welcome on board Ashish Bhandari, the MD and CEO at Thermax Group, to talk to us about what their expectations from budget are. Ashish, hi, good to be speaking with you. Well, CapEx has been one thing which the government has been pushing now. There are experts which are saying that maybe this time around, the CapEx allocation can be as much as 13 lakh crore. But which segment do you think will get the maximum amount of allocation? Any specific reforms that the capital goods segment is watching out for?
We are expecting this to be a landmark budget for the capital goods industry. And we have seen that government spending has been very strong in the last couple of budgets as well. And we would love to see that trend continue. And we would like to see government's expenditure overall in the sector of infrastructure, energy, go up by more than 25%. And a good portion of this going towards energy. Yeah, and associated with this, a big step forward in energy-related jumps that India needs to make, especially in the sector of biofuels, renewable energy, hydrogen, and associated sectors.
Right. Though it's largely known that a continuity of the CapEx policy will be there, any kind of benefits or incentives that are expected to for new emerging areas like EVs, semiconductors, renewables for the capital goods industry?
There would be an expectation on incentives. Overall, I would say the government should continue to focus on keeping its own spending high, but not spending towards areas which will ultimately impact maintaining our current account deficit and our deficit overall, keeping that below the 4.5% number, or at least trending towards the 4.5%. So the incentives that come in should be limited to very specific sectors where new technology is needed and can connect with manufacturing in India. So in that sense, connecting it with PLI benefits makes a lot of sense. Connecting areas where, like biofuels, is a big area where significant policy moves and incentives can be provided to kickstart a sector in a big way in India that can ultimately address India's overall energy imports as well and address climate change and energy transition as well. So keep incentives limited to these very specific areas where manufacturing and energy self-reliance through addition of new technology can be achieved. Otherwise, be tight in providing incentives.
Okay, point taken. But you know, Q1 was partly impacted due to the election-related slowdown, etc. Now, post this election and post the budget clarity is out, do you expect a sizable pickup in terms of execution, even on order inflows?
I would expect the execution of orders to pick up. Almost everywhere where I have talked to customers all across India, there is a continued bullishness. At the recent CII meet, when a large room of CEOs was asked who plans increased CapEx in the remaining financial year, practically every hand went up. So there is an expectation that the environment is right for many companies to accelerate investment, and this is across sectors. So I do expect post the budget for the private capex to also go up in line with how public expenditure is going up.
Right, and how is it that your company is going to capitalize on these government initiatives likely in the budget?
See, we as Thermax, we work on derived demand, which means when government is pushing infrastructure projects, when there is more steel, more cement, more textiles, practically everything else that is needed, those sectors are Thermax's customers. So we provide solutions, energy transition related solutions, water sustainability related solutions, clean air related solutions, to many of these industries that benefit from an overall increase in infrastructure spend, energy spend, which is driven both by government capex spend and also by private capital expenditure.
Right. Okay. Great to have you on the show. Thank you for taking the time out and joining in today.
If you like this video, then like, share, and subscribe to ET Now.